Hello everyone. In this lecture, we'll learn about shell. So what is a shell? When you studied operating system, you must have studied about this diagram that represents operating system, shell, and user. Now, what is operating system? We know without operating system, your laptop, your computer, your system is not going to work and it is going to manage everything. And what are the different services that are being provided by your operating system? It includes CPU scheduling, like, you know, process management, input output operations, process management, right? Resource allocation, security, protection, everything is being done by your operating system. Now, what is then shell? So what is shell? Shell is a user interface for access to operating system services that we have studied. And what does a user do? So basically, a user write program or script, and then the user pass some input to this program or script. And this is being interpreted by your operating system on the basis of which it gives you some output. So input is given by the user in high-level language, and this program is also written in high-level language. But then it is being converted by the operating system in machine language, and then the desired output is being provided. Also, if I talk about the different type of shells, the shells can be of two major categories. We can operate it through command line or through GUI. So let me show you how you can do it through command line. So if I talk about this operating system, this is Ubuntu, in which if you want to operate everything with the help of the command line, then you will simply write the different commands. On the basis of the commands, you are going to get some output. So if I write ls, ls is going to show you all the files and directories available in your system. And also with the GUI, you can see that these are the different files and directories that are being displayed to you through the command line also, right? Similarly, if you want to see the long listing of this file, again, you can see when they were created, how much space they take, what are the different permissions given to these files. Also, there are different other writing the command date. If you want to see the current calendar, you can see that way, right? And also we have other commands. If you want to create a file, so we use this command touch, and I write test, so a test file will be created. Similarly, if you want to create a folder or a directory, then you have to write this. So in this way, a directory will be created, and this is all operated with the help of the command line interface. And for the command line interface, here we are using Linux. And you can see that whatever files we created, those has been created here, because I created test has been created, dir has been created. So that can also be seen from here also. If I write ls, you can see that dir has been created and also your file test has been created. So there are two ways of operating your operating system. There are with this command line interface that can be done with the GUI, and the other way around is GUI. As you can see from here, you have these icons with the help of which everything is displayed, but that is not the case in command line, right? So you can just open it with the click, you can just go anywhere with the help of this click, right? There are different other options given to you. You can do whatever you want. You can do copy, you can move the folders, you can copy the folders, you can move it to trash, rename, everything can be done just with the help of the clicks, this click, mouse click, right? Or by giving some input through the keyboard. But here everything needs to be operated through the, commands. Now come back to the presentation one. Again, so in the command line, we are operating everything with the help of the commands, but in GUI, we have icons which helps us to, you know, easily visualize the operating system, the windows. And similarly, we have click and soft click option with the help of which we can operate on anything, and we have different softwares available. Now coming to the different operating systems available, so the different operating systems available are, we have Windows with us. Most of the people have a habit of working on Windows, then, but industry people love to work on Linux-based systems. and we have Android. This operating system is supported by your mobile phones, smart mobile phones. Then we have Mac OS. Similarly, we have Solaris. So different operating systems are available. So if I show you the Windows, you can see all of us has this Windows. So in Windows also, we have different drives and folders are there. Simply you have to click and you can go to any folder, just clicking it and then opening. And again, these options are given to you, right? So this was all about the operating system and the ways of handling your shell. Now coming to what are the different type of shells which are available. So we have with us two types of, majorly the shells is divided into two types. First is your bourne shell and second is your C shell. So in case of your bourne shell, here this dollar character is default prompt, and in case of your C shell, the percentage symbol is the default prompt, right? And the bourne shell is majorly divided into bourne shell, and the notation here is SH, and for conch shell it is KSH. So your scripts will be having an extension of .sh in this case, and here this bourne shell is represented by SH, conch shell is represented by KSH, bourne again shell by BASH, and then C shell is represented by CSH, and you have your 10x which is represented by TCSH, right? Now here in this course, we will be working in bash shell. And if I talk about this bash shell, it is the most standard shell which is used for writing the shell script. And whenever you have to write a shell script, if I talk about this, we are going to create a program. So on your Linux terminal, you are going to write, you are going to work on any of the editors. So if I choose Nano Editor, there are many editors like Nano Editor, Gedit Editor, Notepad, VI Editor. So I write the name of the editor, I am going to name the file. So I write, let's say I name it as first dot. Now every shell script will be having an extension of sh. So first dot sh. So once you write it, you are going to enter into the script. Now here what you need to do is whenever you are working on any shell script, so in that case, you have to use this shebang operator and the location of that. So every, as you know, in C programming also, you have to, initiate your program by writing hash include stdio.h, in which you are telling the libraries that you are using. After that, you have to use void main, and in the curly brackets, you are writing it, right? Similarly, here also, every shell script has to start with this as the first line. Then you can use some comments, and then you can write some lines of code where you will be using different commands. Okay. And then after this is being done, you will come out of the script, and when you have to run it, you will simply write ./ and then first.sh. So this is the way of creating your shell script, and this is how you run your shell script. And here is shell script. You have written the set of commands that you want to use. So this is how a shell, this in this way you got to know about what is a shell, and with the different type of shells, we will choose bash shell for creating different scripts. And in the next video, I'll be telling you more about the different type of shells, and also I will be also discussing all the different constructs which are required in shell scripting. So till then, stay tuned to my lecture. Thank you so much.